Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Today, inshallah, we're going to solve Cambridge exam October-November 2021, paper 41. Let's start it. Question 1. Some elements are shown in the order they appear in the reactivity series. The most reactive element is at the top. Answer the question using the list of elements. Each element may be used once, more than once, or not used at all. A nonmetal. The only nonmetal here is hydrogen, a metal which is stored under oil. Metals of group 1 are very reactive and stored under oil. Here we have sodium from group 1. The main component of steel. Steel is made from iron, a metal with 3 electrons in the outer shell of its atom, so it's in group 3. The answer will be aluminium. A metal found in brass. Brass is an alloy formed from zinc and copper. So you can write zinc or copper as an answer for this question. A metal that forms chloride of the type XCl2 and XCl3. The answer will be iron, because iron can form two ions with two valences, iron plus 2 and iron plus 3, Fe plus 2 and Fe plus 3. Name the main ore of zinc. The ore of zinc is zinc blend, aluminium. Ore of aluminium is bauxite. In an experiment, a sample of aluminium appears less reactive than expected because aluminium is covered by a protective layer of aluminium oxide on its surface. Name two metals from the list which are extracted by reduction of their ore using carbon. A metal that can be reduced by carbon is a metal below carbon in the reactivity series. Here from the list we can choose iron and zinc, because both below carbon in their activity series can be extracted by reduction of their ores using carbon. Question E. Zinc granules are added to aqueous copper sulfate. Reaction occurs. During the reaction, a red pink solid is formed and the solution becomes colorless. Zinc is more reactive than copper, so zinc displaces copper from its salt and copper formed as a red pink solid. So the answer for question 1 will be copper, and the solution turned to be zinc sulfate. Name the colorless solution. It's zinc sulfate. Explain in terms of particles why the rate of reaction increases when the temperature increases. Increasing temperature increases the kinetic energy of the particles, so the particles move faster and more frequent collision. Increasing temperature increases the number of particles that having energy equal to or more than the activation energy, so more frequent successful collisions and increase the rate of reaction. Suggest other two ways of increasing the rate of reaction. Here in this reaction of zinc plus copper sulfate, other than increasing temperature, we have to write two other ways to increase the rate of reaction. We can use a catalyst, or we can use smaller granules or fine powder of zinc. Question 2. This question is about copper and its components. Copper has two different naturally occurring atoms, copper 63 and copper 65. State the terms used for atoms of the same element with different nucleon numbers. The term is isotope. Isotopes are atoms having the same proton number but different nucleon number. The atomic number for copper is 29, so copper has 29 protons. Complete the table to show number of protons, neutrons, electrons in the particle of copper as shown. The first one, copper 63, it has 29 protons, so it has 29 electrons. And then we will subtract 63 minus 29 to get the number of neutron, which is 34. Then we will go to the next column. Here we have copper plus 2, so it's a positive ion formed by losing 2 electrons, so it has a positive charge of plus 2. Number of electrons has to be less than the number of protons by 2. We have 29 protons, so number of electrons will be 27. And again, to find the number of neutrons, we will subtract 65 minus 29, so copper will have 36 neutrons. Relative atomic mass is the average mass of naturally occurring atoms of the element. Here we have two naturally occurring isotopes. One, copper 63 with percentage of 70% and copper 65 present in 30%. To know the relative atomic mass of copper in this sample, we have to use this formula. We will multiply the each one by its percentage, then we will divide the total by 100, and the relative atomic mass of copper here will be 36.6. B, anhydrous copper sulfate, is used to test for the presence of water. When this test is positive, hydrated copper sulfate is formed. State the color change seen during this test. The color changed from white, which is anhydrous, to the blue, which is hydrated copper sulfate. Complete the chemical equation here. To show this reaction, copper sulfate takes 5 molecules of water to change into hydrated copper sulfate. State how the hydrated copper sulfate can be turned back into the anhydrous copper sulfate. We can remove this water again by heating, and it will be converted into anhydrous copper sulfate. Describe a test for pure water. Test is a boiling point. Water boils at sharp 100 degrees. Or we can say freezing point. Water freeze at 0 Celsius. C. Aqueous copper sulfate contain copper ions. Describe what is seen when aqueous copper sulfate is added to aqueous sodium hydroxide. When we add copper sulfate to sodium hydroxide, a blue precipitate is formed. As we can see from the equation, it is not needed in this question. Copper sulfate reacts with sodium hydroxide to give copper hydroxide, which is a blue precipitate. Write ionic equation for the reaction between aqueous copper sulfate and aqueous sodium hydroxide. Aqueous copper ions plus aqueous hydroxide ions will give a precipitate solid of copper hydroxide. Include the state symbols. So we have to write aqueous for copper ions and for hydroxide ions, and S for the solid copper hydroxide. Here, this question is for 3 marks. 1 mark for the correct ions and charges on the ions, and the second mark for the state symbol, and the third mark for the formula of the product, copper hydroxide, correct formula of the product. Question D. When solid copper nitrate is heated, copper oxide, nitrogen dioxide, and oxygen are formed. Calculate the volume of nitrogen dioxide formed at room temperature and pressure when 4.7 gram of copper nitrate is heated. First, we have to calculate the mass of 1 mole of copper nitrate, adding the mass of copper to the mass of nitrogen and oxygen. The mass will be 188 gram. Then, we want to know how many moles of copper nitrate used. So we will divide the mass of copper nitrate, which is 4.7 grams, by the mass of 1 mole, or the molar mass. So number of moles of copper nitrate will be 0.025 moles. Again, we will refer to the equation here. The ratio between copper nitrate and nitrogen dioxide is 2 to 4. We can simplify to 1 to 2. So number of moles of nitrogen dioxide is double that of copper nitrate. To know the number of moles of copper of nitrogen dioxide formed, we will multiply number of moles of copper nitrate by 2. So the answer here will be 0.05. Then we will use this number of moles to calculate the volume of nitrogen dioxide formed. Number of moles of nitrogen dioxide equal to the volume divide the molar volume, which is 24 decimeter cube for all gases at room temperature and pressure. So the volume will be 1.2 decimeter cube. Write the chemical equation to show the action of heat on sodium nitrate. Sodium nitrate will give different products than that of copper nitrate and sodium nitrate decomposes by heating into sodium nitrite and oxygen gas. Of course, every equation in the exam has to be balanced because one mark here will be for balancing the equation. Question 3. This question is about electrolysis. Concentrated hydrochloric acid is electrolyzed using the apparatus shown. Here we have two carbon electrodes and concentrated hydrochloric acid. Chloride ions are discharged at the anode. Complete the ionic half equation for this reaction. Chloride ions have a negative charge, discharged at the anode by losing two electrons and converted into chlorine gas. So H2 chloride ions will lose two electrons, convert into chlorine gas. State whether this reaction is oxidation or reduction and explain your answer. This reaction is oxidation because chloride ions loses electrons. Describe what is seen at the cathode. Cathode is a negative electrode, so protons will go to the cathode, and what we will see at the cathode is effervescence of a colorless gas, which is hydrogen gas. Write the ionic half equation for the reaction at the cathode. H2 protons will accept two electrons to convert into one molecule of hydrogen. Here, this equation again for two marks. One for the correct ion and charge of the ions, hydrogen, and the second mark for correct formula of hydrogen gas, H2. The pH of the electrolyte is measured through the experiment. Suggest the pH at the beginning of the experiment. Here, we are making electrolysis for concentrated hydrochloric acid. It's a very strong acid and it is concentrated, so the pH will be 1. State how the pH change, if at all, during the experiment. During the experiment, protons of the acid are discharged at the cathode as hydrogen gas. So, of course, removing protons from the solution will make the pH increases. Why? Because proton or hydrogen ions are being removed from the solution. This makes the solution less acidic and the pH increases. E, the electrolysis is repeated using molten lead bromide. Describe what is seen at the cathode. Lead ions will go at the cathode, will discharge as lead metal at the cathode. So what we will see at the cathode is silvery solid. At the anode, bromide ions will go to the anode, losing electron convert into bromine gas. So what we'll see at the end, at the anode is a fizzing of orange gas. State two properties of graphite or carbon make it suitable for being used as electrode. Graphite is inert, so it won't react with the electrolyte or the product of electrolysis. Number two, graphite is a good conductor of electricity. Question 4. Chalcopyrite is used in the manufacture of sulfuric acid in the contact process. In the first stage, it reacts with oxygen in the air to produce three products, which are sulfur dioxide, iron oxide, and copper oxide. First, you have to balance this equation for reaction with oxygen, and one mark for the balance and one mark for the correct formula of the three products: sulfur dioxide, copper oxide, and iron 3 oxide. Sulfur dioxide is then converted into sulfur trioxide by reacting with oxygen, and this reaction is exothermic. It also in an equilibrium. State two features of an equilibrium. Equilibrium is the rate of the forward reaction equal to the rate of the backward reaction. And second, the concentration of the reactant and the product are constant. State the temperature and pressure used in this reaction in contact process. The temperature is 450 degrees Celsius and the pressure is 1 atmospheric.
Name the catalyst used, vanadium pentoxide. Explain why catalyst is used. Catalyst is used to increase the rate of reaction. Describe and explain in terms of equilibrium what happened when the temperature is increased. This is an exothermic reaction. So when we increase the temperature, the equilibrium will be shifted toward the left-hand side or toward the backward reaction because the forward reaction is exothermic. Concentrated sulfuric acid is a dehydrating agent. When glucose is dehydrated, carbon and other products are formed. Complete the equation to show the dehydration of glucose. Dehydration of glucose is removing water from glucose. So the other product formed here will be water and carbon will produce. This equation again for 2 marks, 1 mark for the other product, which is water, and the 1 mark for balancing the equation. Question 5. Alkenes and carboxylic acid are both families of similar compounds with similar chemical properties. Alkene and carboxylic acid have different reactions. 1. State the terms used for families of similar compound, homologous series. State the general formula of alkene, it's CnH2n. The structure of butene is shown. Butene reacts with aqueous bromine in the addition reaction. Describe the color change seen when butene is added to aqueous bromine. The color of the aqueous bromine will be changed from orange to colorless. State what is meant by the term addition reaction. It's a reaction that gives only one product. Write a chemical equation for the reaction between butene and bromine. Butene has a molecular formula of C4H8. When added to bromine, the product will be C4H8Br because bromine will be added here on these two carbons after breaking this double bond. So the formula would be C4H8Br2. Suggest the name of the polymer formed from butene. It will be polybutene or polybutuene. Name and draw the structure of the isomer of butuene. We can change the position of the double bond, writing but1ene, and the double bond will be here at carbon number 1. This will be an isomer for butuene by changing the position of the double bond. Question D. Butanoic acid is a carboxylic acid. The molecular formula of this acid is C4H8O2. Deduce the empirical formula of butanoic acid. The empirical formula is the simplest whole number ratio of the molecular formula. So we will divide these numbers by 2. We will get C2H4O. This will be the empirical formula of butanoic acid. Complete the chemical equation for the reaction of butanoic acid and sodium carbonate. This is butanoic acid. When react to sodium carbonate, it will be, and the products will be sodium butanoate and water and carbon dioxide gas. Butanoic acid react with methanol to form an organic compound. Butanoic acid react with methanol, which is an alcohol, so the product here will be ester and water. Name the organic compound formed. The ester formed is methyl butanoate because the name of the ester is named after the parent acid, which is butanoic acid, so it will be methyl butanoate. Draw the structure of the organic compound formed, which is methyl butanoate. Here is the alcohol part, which is the methyl, and here is the 4 carbons of the butanoic acid. This will be the structure of the ester methyl butanoate. Here we come to the end of our video. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. Wish you all best of luck.